pi method, t method. Today we shall discuss on problems. Okay, a balanced three-phase load of a 30 megawatt is supplied at 132 kV, 50 hertz, and 0.85 power factor lagging by means of a transmission line. The series impedance of a single conductor is, they have given the impedance value and they have given the admittance value. Okay, they have asked to find out the ABCD constants and also VS and regulation. Let's find out. Okay, this is the Z value and this is the Y value. It is in the complex form. Okay, generalized constants, we already know, derived the ABCD equations. Okay, A vector is equal to B vector is equal to what? 1 plus, that is a vector or you call bar. Okay, 1 plus Z bar Y bar divided by 2. So we know the value Z and we know the value of Y. Just to substitute, okay, 1 plus 20 plus J 52 divided by 2 into J 315 into 10 to the power of minus 6. Okay, when you calculate in the complex form, okay, it should be in the R plus JX like that. Okay, it should be in the complex form. Next, you convert in the polar form. Okay, this is in the polar form. You'll get 0.992 at angle 0.18 degree. B vector, Z vector, that is B vector is equal to, there is a formula for T method, that is Z bar open bracket 1 plus Z bar Y bar divided by 4, what we have derived in the last classes. Okay, we know the all values Z bar Y bar, so substitute this and multiply, you will get in the calci. Okay, if you go in the complex form, you will get the direct answer if you calculate this. Okay, so you will get the answer 19.84 plus J51.82, that you convert in the polar form. Okay, you will get 55.5 at angle 69. You keep in polar form or complex form. Okay, C is equal to, that is C vector is equal to Y vector. So they have already given Y value, that you convert in the polar form so that you will get this value. Okay, next is we have find out all the parameters, that is the ABCD constants. Next, we need to find out the sending end voltage, that is VS. What is the VS equation? VS is equal to A vector VR vector plus B vector IR vector. So before going to this equation, first we should know the value of VR and also we should know the value of IR. Okay, because we already know A and B. So receiving end voltage per phase, VR is equal to 132 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by square root of 3. We have converted that, 76.210 kV. Receiving end current, we don't know the value of receiving end current. IR is equal to P value, they have given 30 megawatt. So 30 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 3 into, that is a P divided by 3 into VR into cos phi R. Okay, this is a P value and this is 3 for 3 phase and this is a VR value and this is cos phi R. Okay, you will get IR is equal to 154 amps. So cos phi R is equal to 0.85. Phi R is equal to cos inverse of 85. If you do, you will get phi R value. For that, sin phi R you calculate, you will get 0.53. VR vector is equal to VR plus J0. So VR value 76.210 into 10 to the power of 3 voltage. IR vector is equal to IR cos phi R minus J sin phi R. So IR value is 154 and cos phi r value is 0.85 minus j 0.53, that is sin phi r. When you calculate 131 point minus j 81.62, this is the IR vector. Now we know the all the parameters, so calculate, you'll get 82,428 plus j 5,413, that is what you'll get sending in voltage value. When you do the magnitude of sending end voltage value, you will get 82.6 kilo voltage. Sending end line to line voltage, just multiply square root of 3, you'll get 143 kilo voltage. Next, they have asked you to find out the voltage regulation. So Vs is equal to A VR plus B IR. If you make the IR is equal to 0, what you'll get? Vs is equal to A into VRO. What we want receiving end, that is VRO is equal to Vs divided by A. That they have substituted here, minus VR divided by VR. Okay, Vs value 82.6 kilo voltage and A value 0.992 minus VR value 76.21 kilo voltage into 100 divided by 76.21 kilo voltage. If you do the multiply all the values, then you'll get 9.25%. This is a voltage regulation. Next, similar problem, they have given the A value, B value, D value, C value. Okay, they have all, they have given the all the constants value, and we need to find out here IS. Okay, IS and VS. They have given the A vector and B vector value. Just we need to find out VR, the dividing by square root of 3, you will get the VR value, and IR is equal to P divided by 3 into VR into cos phi R. Next, just you need to calculate IR vector, and VR vector is similar here. So Vs is equal to A vector, VR vector plus B vector, IR vector. Similarly, IS vector is equal to C vector into VR vector plus D vector into IR vector. Okay, just we should find out the IR value and VR value and substitute, you'll get the value, that is 211 minus J36. Okay. Long transmission line, it is lumped constants is applied to long transmission line. In this, they will consider the capacitance value, capacitance parameter, yeah, because it is a long transmission line, long length and also long high voltage. It is found that the serious errors are introduced in the performance calculations. So in order to obtain the fair degree of accuracy, we want the accuracy in a long transmission line, so they consider this in order to get the fair accuracy in the performance calculation of long transmission line, the line constants are considered as uniformly distributed throughout the line length, and here the rigorous mathematical treatment is required for the solution of such lines. You can observe here, there is a uniformly distributed, okay. That is, this is the equivalent circuit of three-phase long transmission line on a phase and neutral basis. The whole line length is divided into n sections. You can observe here, B divided by n. That is, they have divided into n sections. Each section have a line constants, that is 1 by nth of those, that is a whole line. Okay. The following points may be noted that, first, the line constants are uniformly distributed over the entire length of line, and it is the actual case, okay, what we are considering that. The resistance and inductive reactance are the series elements. You can observe, I think, the resistance and inductance are in series, okay, they are series elements. And next, they are saying that leakage susceptance, B, and leakage conductance, G, are shunt elements, that is, it is connected in a parallel. Susceptance and the leakage conductance are shunt elements. The leakage susceptance is due to the fact that capacitance exists between line and neutral. They are saying that capacitance is exist between the line and the neutral. The leakage conductance takes into account the energy loss occurring through the cage over the insulator, or it may be due to the corona between conductors. Okay, in next module, it is the fourth module, corona. Okay, admittance is equal to square root of G square plus B square. The leakage current through shunt admittance is maximum. The leakage current through shunt admittance, what we get is, it will be maximum at the sending end of the line, okay, and decreases continuously as the receiving end of the circuit is approached at which point its value is zero. Okay, what they are saying is leakage current will be maximum at the sending end side and it will be decreases continuously as the receiving end of the circuit is approached, at which the point will be at which point its value will be zero. Next, analysis of long transmission line, that is a rigorous method. Okay, this is a one phase and neutral connection of a three phase line with the impedance and shunt admittance of the line uniformly distributed. You can see this is a lumped circuit and we have written a ZDX. Okay, just we have considered here the resistance and inductance in a Z form. Okay, here B and Z, we have B and G, we have considered that as Y. Okay, here consider a small element in the line of a length dx. Here dx situated at a distance x from the receiving end side. Here z is a series impedance of the line per unit length, and y is a shunt admittance of the line per unit length, and v is a voltage at the ending end of a element towards receiving end. V plus dv means voltage at the end of the element towards sending end. Okay, V is a voltage at the end of an element towards receiving end. You can observe here, V is towards receiving end. V plus dv is towards sending end. Okay, I plus di is current entering the element dx. Here I is equal to current leaving the element dx. Then for small element dx, that is if you observe the here diagram, you'll understand. Dx, okay, z into dx is a series impedance, y into dx is a shunt admittance. You can observe here y into dx, it is connected in a parallel. Okay, so it is a shunt admittance, it is a shunt admittance. Now obviously dv is equal to what we can write dv. Okay, dv is equal to what we can write dv, z into dx into I. Okay, usually voltage is equal to what we will write I into R, but here dv is equal to what we can write z into distance, the distance, z into dx into I. Okay, so dv is equal to I into z into dx. So what you'll get, dv divided by dx is equal to iz. This is the first equation. Next, current entering the element is I plus di. Okay, the what the current entering in the circuit is okay, whereas the current leaving the element is I. The difference in the current flows through the shunt admittance of the element, that is you can observe here, current entering and the current leaving is I. So what we can write the equation here, di is equal to what we can write, di is equal to y into v into dx. Okay, this one. Okay, for dv we will write this one, and for di we will write this one. Okay, y into dx into v. So di by dx is equal to v into y. This is the second equation. Now differentiate equation with respect to x. What you'll get? What is the equation one? What we got is dy divided by dx is equal to I into z. So when you differentiate with respect to x, what you'll get? D square into v divided by d square dx square. That is what, d square v divided by dx square is equal to z into di by divided by dx. Okay, di by dx, or we can write, that is because di by dx is nothing but y into v, that is what they have replaced here. Okay, you can see the equation 2. Okay, d square v divided by dx square is equal to z into y into v. This is the equation 3. Next, the solution of this differential equation v is equal to can be written as v is a k1 cos h x square root of y into z plus k2 sin h x y square root of y into z. This is the equation 4. Now you differentiate the equation 4 with respect to x. What you'll get, dy divided by dx is equal to k1. This inner part, okay, this will become, x will become 1 and square root of y into z. Cos will become sin h x y square root of y into z plus k2 into square root of y into z, because x will become 1 because we are differentiating with respect to x. So it will become 1 square root of y into z cos h, because sin, if you differentiate, you will get cos h x square root of y into z. Okay, but what we got, dv divided by dx is equal to nothing but what, I into z, right? In equation 1, dv divided by dx is nothing but I into z. So we, so what you will get here, I into z, z can be written as square root of z into z, okay? Square root of z into square root of z, okay? This can be written as like this, okay? So k1 square root of y into z, same as it is you write. Next, I is equal to, this z you take in the denominator, okay? So what you will get here, square root of y into z, it is already there. So 1z divided by 1z get cancelled. So you will get square root of y divided by z. Once again I repeat, this y z, okay? So if this z come numerator to the numerator, then 1z will be cancelled. So what you left, square root of y divided by z, okay? So k1 sin h, this will be same. They have taken the common is square root of y by z. This is the equation 5. Okay, next, to find out the value of k1 and k2, there are two cases. Okay, just in equation 4 and 5, they will do that x is equal to 0, v is equal to vr, I is equal to IR. Then if you substitute that, what you'll get, VR is equal to K1. Okay, in equation 4, you'll get VR is equal to K1. So in equation 5, what you'll get, K2 is equal to square root of Z by Y into IR. Okay, this is what you'll get, K1 value, K2 value. Now we know the value of K1 and K2, that you substitute in the equation 4 and 5. After substituting the equation in 4 and 5, you'll get the value, this V value and I value in the terms of Y and Z and in the terms of VR and IR, okay? So this is the value of K1 and this is the value of K2, okay? Just substituted the K1 value and K2 value. After substituting that, next, putting X is equal to L. Okay, I'm putting x is equal to L. Instead of x, you substitute the replace L. Okay, so VR cos h L square root of yz plus z divided by y IR sin h L square root of yz. Okay, replace in instead of x, L. Okay, putting x is equal to L in the above equations, that is VS and also IS. Next, L, that is small L square root of y into z is equal to, if you take this inside, okay, then this will be L square. So Ly into Lz. So that can be written as here, this one total capital Y, this one capital Z. That is what they have written, capital Y is capital Z. Capital Y is nothing but small L, small y. Capital Z is equal to small L, small z, okay. Here, square root of y divided by z is equal to square root of yl divided by zl. That is equal to capital Y divided by capital Z. So, y is nothing but total shunt admittance. Capital Z is nothing but total series impedance. Therefore, expression for VS and IS will become VR. You can observe here. Okay. have n cos h. We have n cos h square root of y into z. Okay. We have cos h square root of y into z. This L square root of y into z will become square root of capital Y capital Z. They have replaced. Okay. Just instead of L square root of y z, you replace capital Y z. Okay. In that place. So what you'll get the equation V R cos h square root of y into z plus I R square root of z by y sin h square root of y into z. IS is equal to VR capital, and that is square root of capital Y divided by capital Z. Okay, here all the capital values, because we have converted first get the equations. Okay, VS equation and IS equation. Next you replace instead of X is equal to 0 and VS is equal to VR, that is instead of V is equal to VR, sorry, instead of x is equal to 0, first IS VS equation, okay, I and V equation, that you replace x is equal to V, x is equal to 0, V is equal to VR and I is equal to IR. After getting the equation, that equation, you just substitute the K1 value, K2 value in that equation. Next, you replace that x is equal to L and replace instead of L square root of y into z as capital Y into z. Okay, replace these terms and you'll get the final equations, this one. Okay, and it is helpful to expand hyperbolic, that is sine and cosine in terms of their power series. This is the cos h square root of yz is equal to 1 plus zy divided by 2 plus z square y square divided by 24. Sin h square root of y into z is equal to square root of yz plus yz to the power of 3 by 2 divided by 6. This is a expander, hyperbolic sine and cosine in terms of their power series. Okay. For the long transmission line. In next class, we shall discuss with the problems on long transmission lines, and also we shall discuss with the other derivations, the important derivations which they have asked in question papers, determination of generalized constants for transmission line, that is a rigorous method, ABCD constants we shall discuss for long transmission line, and also we shall discuss about the parallel, that is a derivation, network in parallel, network in series. Okay.